Alcoholism is one of the deadliest addictions in the world, with over 95,000 deaths per year from this preventable disease. Prolonged overconsumption of alcohol can be deadly. But what if I told you that your body could experience the same symptoms of overconsumption without consuming the alcohol? Well, believe it or not, this actually happened to 61-year-old Donate Giannato. He went to visit his doctor because he was experiencing these unexplained symptoms of intoxication in his everyday life. His wife, Michelle, had urged him to go see the doctor after all of these weird, unexplained intoxication scenarios. She noticed that he seemed a bit more lazy around the house and he was slurring his words all the time. But the only time Don ever really drank was when they had company over, and he assured her that he was not sneaking a swig. So if Don was telling the truth, why was he acting so strangely? What had changed? Don had always been in very good health. However, Don did recently have a nasal surgery and did have a postoperative infection. But the doctors were quickly able to treat his infection with a round of oral antibiotics. But as these new symptoms started to become apparent, Michelle got really nervous because the intoxication episodes were becoming more frequent and they were lasting longer. Her suspicions grew stronger and stronger every day as she noticed that he was slurring his words more frequently. These slurring episodes quickly became bouts of gibberish, and then he became angry and he would just pass out on the floor. And she noticed Don didn't consume one drop of alcohol while he was at home. The following Sunday, Michelle woke up with this awful feeling in the pit of her stomach. So that day, she decided to trust her intuition. Instead of going out and running errands, she decided to stay home with Don. He was a bit slow to get up and kind of sluggishly made his way to the kitchen. Now, Michelle was feeling a bit crazy about the way that she woke up feeling that day, so she went to take a shower to try to calm her anxiety. Emerging from the shower, she heard Don coughing in the bedroom, and she ran in there and noticed that he was having a full-blown seizure right there on the bed. Don was rushed to the ICU, where he spent the next week recovering, where doctors ran every test in the book and they could not find anything wrong with him. Not only were they not able to figure out what was wrong with him, but they noticed that his intoxication had completely dissipated over the course of that week and not come back. After almost 2 weeks in the ICU without figuring anything out that was going on with him, the ICU doctors were forced to release him to go home, and they told Michelle, please bring him back at the moment's return of any of his symptoms. Michelle waited patiently, and sure enough, 3 weeks later, his symptoms reemerged. So Michelle eagerly rushed him back to the ICU in hopes that they would finally figure out what was going on with Don. Now, unfortunately, medicine isn't always that simple, and the doctors yet again could not figure out what was going on, and they told Michelle, maybe on the third time if he comes back, we'll be able to figure it out then. Over the next 14 months, Don would be admitted to the hospital over 22 times, and they never were able to figure out what was going on. With each admission, the doctors noticed that he was getting worse and worse every time. You see, prolonged alcohol consumption can lead to alcoholic liver disease and get worse and worse, causing fibrosis and damage to the liver with time. This is also known as alcoholic liver cirrhosis, and unfortunately for Don, this cannot be reversed. Over the 14 months of hospital visits and declining liver function, slowly but surely his body was becoming unable to clear all of the excess liquid. The problem is, drinking alcohol also makes it harder for the body to clear out excess liquids. This all centers around alcohol's relationship with a hormone in the body called antidiuretic hormone. Now, normally, antidiuretic hormone allows you to conserve fluid. It is antidiuresis. When you drink alcohol, it blocks antidiuretic hormone, and that's why you pee like crazy when you drink, because you're not holding on to the fluid. Because of his alcoholic cirrhosis, he gained over 60 pounds in fluid retention weight. Because of the massive fluid retention, his lungs were not able to oxygenate very well, so he had to be put on oxygen 24/7. After performing multiple tests on his lungs to see if he actually had any lung disease, it showed nothing. After Michelle spoke to over 100 doctors across the country trying to figure this out, she had lost all hope in the medical system. She was so exhausted that she decided she and Don needed a break. So they drove down to Long Island to visit some of her family for Thanksgiving. Little did Michelle know that this getaway was going to provide her with the information that she was so desperately seeking. After breaking down the past 14 months and everything they had been through, Michelle finally got the break that she was looking for. Her cousin's wife had just returned from an unusual medical conditions conference. She learned about something called Auto Brewery Syndrome. Michelle was like, this matches everything that Don is going through. She told Michelle to go purchase a breathalyzer and to measure Don's blood alcohol level the next morning. So the next morning she measured it and it came in at 0.20%, which is 3 times the legal blood alcohol driving limit. Michelle took Don to the hospital immediately. But instead of running the usual test, she asked the doctors to run a test called a high carbohydrate challenge under very strict supervision. So once the doctors normalized Don's blood alcohol level, they started to give him a high carbohydrate challenge and they observed him over the next hour. He got bread, pasta, chocolate cake, I mean everything that you would not want someone in the hospital to have. After pumping him full of carbohydrates, the doctors then tested his blood alcohol level again and they were astonished. Everyone was running into the room and placing an IV and checking his blood pressure to see what was going on. And there Michelle sat. Nurses reassured her, no worries, we know exactly what's happening, we just need to stabilize him. Don's lactic acid levels were so high that he began to run a fever. His blood pressure was extremely high and his blood alcohol levels were through the roof. Hearing the worsening news about her husband's condition, she could only think, thank God. After nearly 2 years of dead-end tests and multiple hospital visits, we finally know what's going on. Her cousin's wife was right. Don had been suffering from Auto Brewery Syndrome. With this syndrome, your body takes any high carbohydrate load and converts it into alcohol. So Auto Brewery Syndrome can be caused by taking antibiotics for an infection like Don did for his nasal infection, or from a fungal infection which leads to yeast overgrowth which causes the production of alcohol. For those of you out there who like to drink beer, if you recall, in the making of beer, yeast breaks down carbohydrates to form alcohol. Initially, it was really difficult for doctors to figure out how to treat Don's Auto Brewery Syndrome. But after doing extensive research, they realized that using some IV anti-yeast medication would help resolve his symptoms. 2 months later, Don's Auto Brewery Syndrome had finally reversed. And after 2 weeks, he was back on his feet and working again. At the suggestion of his doctors, Michelle encouraged Don to become a speaker for Auto Brewery Syndrome. Now, initially, Don was reluctant because of Auto Brewery Syndrome's relationship to alcohol. But after meeting other people suffering from the same condition, he had a change of heart. After hearing about their hardships, Don realized that he needed to share his suffering and his experience in order to try to help other people. Because of Don's efforts, he and many other people came forward bringing Auto Brewery Syndrome to the forefront, which had never been discussed in public very much before. And when the medical community comes together, as well as families who have other people in medicine, we can really find out answers that maybe all the smartest minds in the hospital would never otherwise be able to sort out. Had her cousin's wife not gone to that medical conference, she may have never found out what was wrong with Don. I can tell you personally, I had never heard of this syndrome until I came across this story, and for sure, it's something that I thought would be rare, and I'm amazed at how actually common it is. As it turns out, Auto Brewery Syndrome is not really a rare condition, it's just rarely diagnosed because no one really knows to look for it. Now, the world may have taken away Don's sanity and his health, but all he wanted to do was to give back to others. He tirelessly worked with other people to try to help diagnose and get them treated so that they wouldn't have to suffer the damage that his body suffered. His passion for educating about Auto Brewery Syndrome led to real change in the world. And that is why it pains me to tell you that 2 years after his diagnosis, he passed away from chronic liver disease and other damage that Auto Brewery Syndrome had done to his body. Don didn't take a second to rest, and he spent his final time on Earth trying to help other people suffering with this dreadful disease.